down the pitch, and a classic cover drive in the end. The sort of shot you play off a spinner. But Tucker looking to be aggressive.
Down the wicket again. Watch his head very, very still, which allows him to make good contact with the ball and stay in control. Good batting.
Yeah, that was a lovely shot. Spurted through the third man region, and it will go away for four. Batting has been tricky this morning. Take them however you get them. Yeah, that's placed nicely. 50 partnership between Tector and Tucker. Excellent batting.
Resilience. Both have a lot of talent. Tucker in particular has played with a lot of control.
Driven slightly off the inside edge of the bat, but the outfield's got quicker day by day, and that's another boundary to Tucker and Ireland.
Touch fuller from Broad. Full value at Lord's. Field in great condition. Good time to bat.
Hey!
Got him. Played it on. Went to sweep it very fine. And finally a breakthrough. Jack Leach provides it.
From Lorc and Tucker. Front pad a little bit too far across. In fact, he's a little unfortunate. Comes off the glove and back onto the stumps.
Goes over long on, and a couple of bounces and just trickle into the boundary before. Good aggression from Harry Tech.
Quite out of the middle of the bat. Fully committed. Nice bit of aggression over the top. Field will stay up though.
A terrific placement as well. Timing. Taking it from a roundabout middle and off stump, I think. Decided to go on the attack, Curtis Camphor.
Throw down the gauntlet to the bowler. Fields up. Bang him over the top. And we see the response from Leach.
Into the grandstand, that is a lusty blow. Nicely driven. Up the slope for four. Second four for Camphor.
Seen him slog sweep route into the grandstand. It's a good cover drive to the fence.
Last ball of the 41st. Aims a drive through point, and he squirted it through mid-on. And it has gone all the way to the boundary in front of the pavilion.
Yeah, he was aiming a repeat measure, wasn't he, through the offs.
And he's watched that nicely. Placed it through mid-off. And that's enough to take Tector to 50. Boy's gone. 50 and out. A length ball with a bit of width, and really Tector has just guided that into the hands of Harry Brook.
From Josh Tong. And he just steers it to backward point where Harry Brook takes it on the second grab. He just clutches it into his midriff. And that's real frustration for Tector. Switch your mind off.
Catch again. Stokes hobbles a little bit, but he's taken the catch safely. And Ireland are starting to implode here.
It's swept. Catchable height. Pretty straightforward catch. But just watch the reaction here. Yeah.
Wait!
A shot. Gonna be a teaser. Ooh. Oh, got into a bit of a tangle. He done the first bit pretty well, not the second bit. Josh Tong. done again. That's a better shot, beautifully timed.
I think T liked it as well.
Next one to go down the slope, Joe.
Heaved away, leg side. Nice blowy over the boundary.
Well, Root is bowling to the short side as the off-spinner. We've already seen Curtis Camphor put one into the top tier of the grandstand. This is a slightly longer boundary because it's gone into the pocket.
This time the sweep for four, productive over for Ireland. 184 for six.
That gets past fine leg and Root, who is square right between the two of them.
Just thinking round the wicket is an option to bring the angle a little bit more into the bat.
Does go leg side, he drags it because Root saw him coming, and that will go up the hill away for four.
Really well bowled by Root, but this one drags short, a lot slower, bites, turns inside half of the bat, and lucky to fall into the gap.
And that goes all the way into the grandstand, dropped in the crowd.
Exactly what he wanted the batter to do, the fielder was well set. Mark Cadet just timed it a little bit too well, and it's 20 yards past and over.
That's nailed, absolutely nailed. The only person in trouble there was the square leg umpire. Very good from Adair, 208 for six.
Runs behind now. Getting the ball to drop and to drift nicely.
He'll be tempted. He is tempted, but he swept it fine for the second time in the open.
Isn't it? Unless you're Shane Warne, trying to rip the ball round behind the right hander's legs from the rough. And again, I'm not entirely sure why.
Good shot. Played a few of those today, and it's the third that I can think of that he's driven nicely through the offside and up the hill to the short boundary.
Left hander driving that square out of the rough is just, you have to just wait that fraction long.
Ooh, driven firmly just past Leach's outstretched right hand. Very good shot, hit with real power, because Harry Brook, who's out there on the boundary, didn't have far to go to his left. Oh, terrific drive again from McBride, who did exactly what Mark Butcher suggested a left-hander has to do. Excellent. Right over the keeper's head, and an excellent way to go to a half century. That was deliberately played, a short ball from Broad, and just helped away. Tickled fine this time, and Broad just erring to leg. Four more. Three consecutive bounds.
And that's why that away, away through mid-wicket. A little bit agricultural, but effective.
Cross-seam delivery. Ah, that's really well played again by Adair. That's another boundary. Waited on it, guided on it, guided it. Soft hands through that third man region. 271 for six.
Wait, wait, wait!
Ah, that's really well played. Well bowled, a little short. and McGrind just riding the bounce and guiding it. One choice, and he's going to play every single time they need one, but every now and then with a left-hander, you stray a little bit too full. And that is a great shot.
And again, four more, this time a little bit straighter. And Brian is approaching a half century. He's now 49, that's 289 for six. The reverse will bring up a test match half century for Andrew McBrien, his second, and a boundary it is that takes him to 53 and takes this partnership to 137.
To McBrien.
Like that, but that squirted away off the outside the edge down for another boundary.
Catch!
Continue to attack Jack Leach. And he's attacked that one enough to get it away for four. Swung away leg side, another boundary. This is excellent from Ireland, 318 for six. Ooh. That's gorgeous. Ooh, as he edged it through, he has. Can you believe it? He's played that shot so effectively in his innings.
Well, it's the continued cross seam, short ball plan. Just a feather off the outside edge.
Well, he's played that quite beautifully. I was a bit harsh on him a little earlier. I felt it was a bit outside edge. You quite rightly made the point that there was a sense of deliberation about that.
Oh yes, it is five for Josh Tong on debut. What a moment for him. Smart catch to second slip. He had to wait a long time for his first test wicket, but he shone in the second innings here.
This for Josh Tong. Big drive, firm edge, well taken by Zach Crawley, moving to his right. And a chance to hold the Duke's ball high and take the applause of the crowd. What a moment. A couple of England spinners of late have taken five wickets on debut. We saw slashed away. Ireland trail by three. And the cheers that greet that boundary are because Ireland lead by one. England will have to bat again.
I'm going to put on a brave face. On the route, it'll be four. Is off the outside edge of Hume's bat. Bowled out. That has gone past the outside edge, and Broad picks up the ninth wicket. And we feel with the problems that James McCollum has had in the moon boot situation, that will be the end of the innings. First innings, can he get it right in the second? Oh, Crawley's underway with a lovely pull shot first up. Way to the boundary for four.
How are England going to go about it? Again, extremely positive. Length just a little bit short and Crawley.
Offside, up the hill, four more for Crawley.
Stands tall, does Zach Crawley. This is just the punch. Very elegant and easy on the eye when he's in this sort of form.
Drives down the ground. Three fours in the over for Zach Crawley. And 11 wins out of 13 under this regime that has turned England cricket around. It has made them so, so good to watch. And that is a convincing win. Ireland made them fight in the second innings.